bold statement here, but ChatGPT is not magic.
Wait, what?
I know, right? It does feel like it sometimes. But the truth is, it just follows instructions really well if you know how to give them. Prompt engineering may sound scary, but it really isn't that deep. It's just about asking better questions in plain, real people language. So if you've been struggling to actually get good answers from ChatGPT, then you are in the right place, because I'm gonna show you how to get ChatGPT to think with you, not just for you. We'll turn your messy brain dumps into real business strategy, write better prompts using a dead simple framework, and I'll share the exact templates that I use every week to plan content, run campaigns, and save hours of time. Now, it is your lucky day because I have a little cheat sheet for you. If you want more than 1,000 pre-written prompts, HubSpot and Mindstream dropped a free prompt library that is basically a cheat code to running your business smarter. I'm gonna show you how to use it properly throughout the video, and I've linked it below. And trust me, you're gonna want it. Okay, so before we get into the video, it's confession time. I use ChatGPT literally multiple times a day. I'm not even joking. Am I embarrassed by that? To be honest, I don't know. But I do have a secret that nobody wants you to know. So sometimes I open ChatGPT, right? And I just stare at it like, what do I even say to you right now? So here is the lazy genius move. If you don't know what to prompt, just ask ChatGPT to write the prompt for you. This is a little trick I use when I feel stuck. I follow this GPT framework. G stands for goal. Tell ChatGPT what you're trying to achieve. P stands for position. Explain who you are or the role that you're working from. T stands for template. Ask ChatGPT to write the best prompt template to help you get results. So, let's say you're trying to write a newsletter, but you don't know how to brief ChatGPT. You can just type, I want to write a weekly email to my list. That's the goal. I'm a vegan skincare business owner. That's your position. Write me a prompt template that will help me get a good draft. That's the template part. Let's send it and see what we get. Cool. So then you can fill out that template and use that to get the email written. You are now one layer removed from writer's block. But here's the thing, even the best prompt in the world won't work if ChatGPT doesn't know you. So before you start prompting, you need to get clear on the foundation. Prompts don't work if ChatGPT has no clue who you are or what you do. So before you start prompting, you need four core pieces of context. Your business description, so what do you sell and who do you serve? Your unique selling proposition, or USP. Why should people choose you? Your audience persona. Who are you talking to? What do they care about? And finally, their challenges. What are they struggling with? Now, if you don't already know these, of course you can use ChatGPT to help you out. You can do this in two different ways. Option one, drop your website link into ChatGPT and say, analyze my website and give me 1 to 2 sentences for each of the following. Business description, USP, audience persona, and top customer challenges. Option two, just brain dump everything you know about your business into ChatGPT, and then ask, based on this, can you give me 1 to 2 sentences for each of the following? My business description, USP, audience persona, and top customer challenges. Pretty cool, eh? Well, save those somewhere easily accessible, because now we're gonna use them to supercharge your prompts. Let's put those foundational pieces to work using some of my favorite prompts from the HubSpot and Mindstream prompt library. These are high leverage, low effort, and get some serious stuff done. So here in the prompt library, I am going to copy the prompt that I wanna use and paste it into ChatGPT. Then I'm going to fill out everything in brackets with the foundational pieces that we just created. If you're looking to build a social strategy, you can try this prompt. Develop a social media content strategy for, insert your business description, that showcases, insert your unique selling point, and appeals to, insert your audience persona, while addressing, insert their challenges. You now have a game plan and know what to post and why. If you want to take a peek at what your competitors are doing, try this one. Conduct a competitive analysis to identify how, insert your business description, can differentiate itself from rivals and better highlight its, insert your unique selling points. 2, insert your audience persona. This is amazing for brand positioning, especially when you feel like everyone's offering the same thing. You can stand out with the right messaging. If you want to update your pricing to be a bit more competitive based on the current market, try this. As a, insert your business description. Targeting, insert your audience persona. What pricing strategy should we use to highlight our, insert your unique selling points, while staying competitive in the current market? Use this when you're reworking your pricing page or launching a new offer. If you need a website update, try identify 3 key areas on insert your business website that can be optimized to better communicate, insert your unique selling point, and appeal to, insert your audience persona. Send it to your web designer or use it as a checklist for your homepage refresh. If you're running ads, try write ad copy for insert your business description, targeting, insert your audience persona, highlighting our insert your unique selling point while addressing their key challenge of insert audience challenges. Use this in Meta or Google Ads campaigns to immediately connect with your audience's pain points and position your brand as the solution. The idea of distribution can be completely overwhelming with all the options. If you want to know where to focus your efforts, try create a distribution strategy for insert your business description that targets insert your audience persona by leveraging insert your unique selling point to overcome insert audience challenges and reach new customers in untapped markets. Use this to plan your next campaign, social rollout, or newsletter launch. So those are 6 of my favorite prompts from the prompt library, and there are literally 1,000 more plug and play examples listed for you in that prompt library. It's organized by business categories like SEO, marketing, social, productivity, you name it. I've been using it like a second brain and it's linked below for free. So let's quickly recap. If you are not sure how to prompt, use the GPT framework. If you want better results, set your prompting foundation. If you want to skip the guesswork, use the free prompt library. Follow these steps and you'll be best friends with ChatGPT in no time, like me. If you want a boost to get started, drop your business type and goal in the comments and I'll give you a prompt to try out. Thanks so much for hanging out with me. If you liked this video, let me know by giving it a thumbs up. And hey, if you want to hang out again, my name is Bridget and I'll be here every week. So make sure to hit that subscribe button for tons more videos to help make your marketing strategy 10 times easier. Speaking of making your marketing strategy easier, have you heard about marketing automation? I'm gonna link a video at the end of this one that will give you a beginner-friendly 2-week plan to automate your marketing so that your business runs while you sleep. My name is Bridget O'Rourke. Feel free to connect with me online and I'll see you next week. Bye.